Hello and welcome to October, a tale of three cities. This month started in London with a fun shoot for Fun Science. Then I flew to New York mid-month to have a couple of cool meetings and meet up with some old friends. Then I flew to Toronto for Buffer Festival, where I met a bunch of you guys, watched Bertie Gilbert eat a lot of poutine, and screened my first animated short called Happy. This is October. Anywhere.
Yeah, but you're not going to change it, are you?
Where do you want to be?
It's just going to be green.
Where do you want to be? This is Hello and Welcome to October. Where do you want to begin October?
Space.
Hello and welcome to October. We're in space.
No, we're not. This is still green.
Is that the editing, Hazel? Don't leave. I'll be in space now without you.
We've taken a change.
The beat's changed.
Oh, I know. Okay, good, right? Oh, now comes the scarf. Let's hope it ends there. Let's go.
I don't know about you, Dan, but this is getting me a lot of views.
Okay.
I'm kidding.
I've got my hand in my bag. Am I going to pull out something? Beauty, lifestyle, or fashion?
It's super lifestyle.
Okay, come on. Lifestyle.
Oh, John! I'm so sorry to tell you. Okay. Is everything to play for now?
Yeah.
It always is. And we're about to pull out beauty.
Always everything to play for. Never not everything to play for.
Just fully commit.
Okay, come on.
It's all or nothing, baby.
Here we go. Could you close your legs a bit?
Beauty, gonna be fashion, or lifestyle?
Beauty.
Come on.
Hazel, I am sorry.
Oh, it's fashion.
So here's the thing that's happening that's very exciting. I'm currently waiting on my balcony for a car to come pick me up to go to the BFI London Film Festival gala, which is like kind of this big opening ceremony where they're going to announce the winner of a bursary award, where one very lucky director is going to win £50,000 towards their next project. That is not going to be me. I'm not up for it. I'm just going. And the IWC, who are a watch company that sponsor the event, are sending me along. I normally wouldn't just vlog to tell you what I'm about to do. I'd just cut to what I'm doing. But I'll be honest, I'm a bit bored. Oh, I've got a pretty dress. That's the thing. I've got a pretty dress. Pretty dress. Isn't it pretty? From Ted Baker. So, I mean, I get to wear a pretty dress and go out and feel a bit like a princess for the night. So that's all I really need in life. Really, and Cheetos, obviously. Now, I've just been to collect my watch, which is very lovely, it's very beautiful, this is it. I'm gonna wear this onto the red carpet now. It's 15 grand, just on my wrist. I'm just walking around 15, and she's like, when do you want to return it? I'm like, I don't know, at some point this evening. I might give it back to one of the staff members to bring up. She was like, you're responsible for that now. So maybe you bring it. So I probably will. I hope you've either enjoyed me talking or him dancing. There's a lot to choose from there. This is your host, Odie Clark. Me. I've got a spooky face.
And cheetahs.
Cheetahs.
2.50.
2.50, mate.
And his one ate all the dust. What?
I licked that chick clean. Oh, wow. Wow. Did you just do a Bane impression in the Cheetos?
I just want to say thank you so much for coming to see the movie. We were all able to sort of congregate here in London, and I've been so just, I love London as a city, but I also love any excuse I have to show a film here. So I've been waiting for this for these few days for a while.
Oh my God.
And Ryan came over from Budapest and hasn't done much sleeping lately. But we've just been so kind of energized by being here and by the city. So I just want to thank all of you for coming and watching the movie, and I really do hope you enjoy it. Now, Ryan, it's something really, really deep and profound.
I hope you enjoy the film. From what I understand, you haven't paid for these tickets, so if you don't, it's not really a big loss for you, is it? But I hope you enjoy it nonetheless.
That was Ryan Gosling. That was Ryan Gosling there.
Hazel literally said, I need to do an intro bit, and that's all I know. I have no idea what...
That was Ryan Gosling at...
...preceding this clip.
A screening of La La Land the other day.
Oh, you bitch.
Talking about, that was Ryan Gosling. Let me just, once again, in a room with Ryan Gosling, and he said words.
I've been in a room with Ryan Gosling and he said words.
And I took out my camera to vlog, right? Yeah. And Jack went, you're looking at the screen, you're not even looking at him. Like, Jack, on my behalf, was like, Hazel, it's Gover. Don't miss out on this.
He's a very handsome chap, isn't he?
He's very handsome.
Was he wearing a suit?
I can't remember, was he?
I don't know.
That was him introducing the film, which I saw and isn't out until January here. And it's on my list of best films ever.
Ever?
And that's ever. It was reminiscent of like Singing in the Rain.
Oh, don't, that's one of my favourite films.
It is one of my favourite. It's like a modern day Singing in the Rain. That was Ryan Gosling, and this is me and Dan cleaning up confetti, which is on the floor because we just did a video for Pot Noodle wherein there was confetti.
Yeah.
I'm about to do a tipsy talk with Amy Adams, who I'm a huge fan of. She's just starred in a film called Arrival, which I loved. So I'm really keen to talk to her about that. I haven't eaten today either, so I'm going to go really easy on it.
Oh no, I'm not.
Like, it's lots of views.
Wow. If you give me an exclusive, I'll get lots of views. That's what happened with Margot.
Oh, what did she say?
She basically revealed the spin-off of Harley Quinn's movie.
Right.
Are we rolling?
We're
sorry.
Oh, okay, great. That's all right.
Yes,
cheers.
No, cheers to you too.
I am a mess. I am a mess. Here we go. I am a mess. How old are you?
I am 31.
31. It gets really good.
Does it get better in the 30s?
It gets
great.
30s were good. 20s for me.
My 20s were not.
Hot mess McGee. Yeah. And it was the best thing that nobody was watching me in my 20s. And that's
okay.
Like not even half a glass. That's telling.
Go and see a film.
Yeah.
My tea is leaking.
We're going to go see this film.
This film specifically.
Their finest.
It's rom-com.
Starring Bill Nye the Science Guy.
Bill Nye the Science Guy and Gemma Arterton. Oh, have I got my finger on the fucking microphone again? Dan, where's the mic?
It's at the bottom, where you would talk if you were answering.
No, that's the mic.
No, that's where you get in your SIM card.
Think I better leave right now before I fall any deeper. I think I better leave right now. It's getting weaker and weaker. Somebody better show me how before falling.
Are they okay?
Yeah, Hazel just.
Can I just say?
She just fell on the floor while she was trying to get a low angle shot. There's an Uber outside. Jack's ready to go.
100% sober.
Yeah.
I have to leave now.
Where's my
bye.
Right now.
Bye, Hazel.
I think I'd better leave right now.
You might want to take this.
Yeah, good. Hello and welcome to day one in New York. Well, it's kind of day two. I was not capable of vlogging yesterday. I just wasn't able. I have a bit of a flu, as I'm sure you can hear. I was jet lagged, I was tired, I was hungry. Right now, I am headed to meet with somebody at CISO, which is sort of a digital branch of NBC, to talk about my sitcom. This is just all I ever tell you is I'm on my way to meet people to talk about my sitcom. I'm on my way to meet with someone from HBO today. Then I'm going to fill my face full of pancakes and go to Central Park.
Sexy.
The third and final debate between Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump less than 3 minutes away. The backdrop, a day of surprise guest announcements and campaign stunts. Trump behind in the polls in need of a game-changing moment.
See,
calling
to
Dan.
Protect the country, and how do you believe the Constitution should be interpreted?
Well, first of all,
I'm a fucking asshole.
Hi. Time of the month from abroad.
Dan, you join me live from New York, where I am about to open a pizza and some cheesecake and watch the fucking debate. I would like to talk about how fucking radiant Hillary Clinton looks.
I mean, yeah, she dresses a lovely space
cadet. She's dressed like the general of a space federation once again, and I love her for it. I've just had an amazing day in New York. It's just been really lovely. My voice is still weird because I've been sick. And throughout that, I have been in constant contact with Kaylee and Chloe and Tom Barnes and Dan Pugsley. We're all working on this short, this poem thing that I'm making for Buffer. And so we're trying to get that ready for tomorrow. So I've been kind of doing a bit of work, but just chilling out as well. And it's been nice. I was supposed to meet Akila tonight, but we've decided to be old ladies and stay in instead. Gil. You may remember Gil from such videos as that one I did last Christmas.
Been a while.
It's been a whole year. It's been nearly exactly a year.
Exactly. It was cold last year. It's not this year.
It was cold last year, so I packed like woolly scarves and jumpers and stuff. And then I got here, it's like 25 degrees.
It's not an intelligence issue. It really is just a climate change.
It's awful. It's crazy. So, look, what's happened is I've had 2 days essentially alone. I was going a little bit crazy. I needed pancakes. And
we actually had to change restaurants to go get you pancakes. That's 100% true.
We met a lady who was giving out...
Goal for pizza!
New York.
Yeah, welcome to New York, where people yell about pizza all the time. The most New York moment ever. Guy yelling about pizza.
We met a lady who was giving out good deed dares.
We each got one. My nice deed dare is to tell someone you appreciate them. So now I have to go find someone I appreciate. So
that's just a guy in the Washington Square fountain. Having a great time. Good for you, dude. We're looking for an Urban Outfitters because I'm so fucking hot.
It's really hot.
I'm gonna just buy a dress and chain because this is ridiculous.
Where are you? Tell me where we are.
Well, Gil, we are near a bridge.
No, that's so far away. We're not anywhere near. Wait, turn around and show the bridge that is way closer.
Yeah, but this is the one that has the flag.
What?
Shut up. There's a bridge.
Okay.
Where?
The tram in Spider-Man, where he like saved Mary Jane and had to hold another tram. It's like right there.
It's there, trust us.
This was the best thing we've done today.
What's it called?
The Queensboro.
Roosevelt Bridge.
No.
We have a reunion tonight, and he's on the phone to Jeff to try and get him to come. The reunion being that Christmas video that I did in New York last year. Gil was one of the actors, Jeff is another actor. Anna, the co-director, is going to be there. Carlos, the DOP, Kate and Kyle, who are the art department. I don't know who else is coming, but we've just randomly all decided to get together, and that's what we're going to do.
I'm Hazel Hayes, and I love my old pink hair, which I don't have anymore, and I love that I'm walking on the street in New York.
Look at you.
Look at
you.
I didn't mean to do that. Oh, shit. I stayed up pretty late working with Kaylee trying to get the animation finished for this video. Also Dan Putsey is working on sound right now. Tom Barnes has sent over the composition for it. It's all coming together. Chloe's done a little bit of her as well. So that was last night. This morning I'm up, I'm packed-ish, and I'm ready to go to Toronto for Buffer. Let's do this. I literally just walk in, they've just got off a flight from London. And I've just come in from New York. Woo!
Where are we going?
I'm so tired, they're so tired. We're trying to find a buffer person.
We're looking for a representative.
We're looking for a representative.
Someone to represent me.
I said today that I missed Sammy and I was really looking forward to seeing him. It's been 5 minutes.
Death.
He's a madman. He's gone mad. He's gone mad.
I'm coming. I'm traveling in style.
Sorry.
It's coming. Are we late? Coming.
He's down. And he's down. Oh, Sammy. Sammy.
What are we gonna do? Just like
just carry the bleeding case.
Hey, good mate.
Good to be back in the Fairmont. I've just seen someone vlogging and I thought, what a dickhead. And then I realised I do that. So I'm sorry for being a dickhead. Adrian, he's leaving, he's off out. He's out. But look, we're back in the Fairmont and it's nice to be back.
So everything you hate is everything you
it is actually. I mean, I feel particularly awkward today. Right. I really do. Every time I get a camera, I'm like, he hates me, he hates me.
He does.
Like Tim, I love you.
Good morning. Kaylee has just sent me over the very final version of Happy with Tom Barnes' beautiful music on it. So I'm going to take a look now, and hopefully this will be screened at the Women of YouTube panel today. Let's take a look.
I just want to be happy, she said. Then she cried. Because for years now she had tried and failed to catch it, to hold it, to keep it. She searched for Happy. She set up camp and she watched and waited, its absence amplified by her impatience. She hunted it, like prey. She stalked it and followed it day after day, and sometimes spied it up a distant hill, but running, shouting at Happy, we couldn't scare it away.
I'm sitting next to, like, the fucking poetess goddess of the world, and I'm like, I've never got enough. I wasn't supposed to screen that. I was supposed to screen September time of the month, and I tried to write a poem to go in the middle of September, and when I started doing it, I realised this was its own thing, and I sort of sat on a sofa all day and just wrote and wrote, and this just came out, and it weirdly became this semi-autobiographical thing about how documenting my life has, it's a blessing and a curse. We all have our shit, we all have anxiety, we all have like depression. I realised I was talking to someone earlier and I was like, yeah, I'm having a mental breakdown. She's like, yeah, me too. I'm like, we're not fucking special. Like, the fact that you're saying, like, people go, I'm so special, I'm so sad and deep, and like, no one gets it, everyone gets it, everyone's fucked. So like, when I'm sad or when shit's not going well, like last year with the breakup, when I have to sit down and edit the footage, or talk to you guys when I don't feel like talking, it's really hard. But similarly, it's also nice when I'm down to go back through footage, and that's what was happening in September. I was looking at all the footage going, oh my God, this is lovely. Like when you actually stop and look at the nice moments from your life, you see all the lovely, happy times, and they're usually when you weren't expecting it. You don't see it happen, but suddenly happiness is just there, and you can't keep it, it's really fleeting. You can keep all the other shit and carry around like luggage, it's great. But you don't seem to keep a bag with happy in. So that was just a little reminder to everyone that it is there. Go back through your photos and go back through your videos or whatever of your life, and you'll realize that you see it.
So me and Gil are just out on the town. He booked a restaurant. I was like, I'd like some pizza. He's like, oh, I'll buy a pizza place. We found a place called what? Uncle Tony's?
Uncle Tony's.
Uncle Tony's. It seemed like, that seems like, but.
It seemed like small.
We just got here. Can you see? It's so romantic. It's so romantic.
I'm sorry.
There's candlelight. There's a gentleman just playing music in the background.
What have I done? I feel like you're gonna put the moves on me.
I might propose. I might just propose because the place is so nice.
Tim's here now. It's just got more romantic.
Good morning. I'm on my way to my screening Q&A thing. It was a late night. Pretty hungover. Everything is so loud, bright. It's gonna be fun. I'm winging it. Winging it is the word of the fucking day. Stuart. Great.
Whenever I do make anything, I try and address it to someone in my head. Maybe it's my future self or my past self or whatever. But I try and think like I'm talking to one person who is often some version of me. But that is often some version of everybody else, because we are kind of all in the same boat. And then it developed, and I thought, yeah, I could make this and I could put it up, and hopefully there would be some nice message in it for other people. I think we go through life sometimes thinking, yeah, like, why am I not happy? I just want to be happy. And like, that's not the range of human emotion, you know? That's not how we've evolved. Like, suffering is a large part of what being human is, and without, you know, without fear, we wouldn't protect ourselves, and without sadness and pain, we wouldn't learn not to make the same mistakes again. And, you know, all those things kind of have to happen. And in a way, having those means that the happy times and the good times are so much nicer and so much more important. So I think I look around at me and my friends and all of you guys, I don't know what's going on in your lives, but you've all got your stuff. And you've all got your bad days, and I think, yeah, for once, I think I usually try and entertain people with blood and gore and horror and dark shit and let them escape for a little bit from that, and this time I wanted to kind of remind them that there are good times in there as well instead. Do something nice.
I feel like I'm filming The Office
I've
right now.
I've got a gift for Dan from New York. He said to bring him something tacky.
When people go places, they're always like, do you want anything? I'm like, yeah, bring me back something tacky. And I like to see how they interpret the brief. I once received a dragon whistle from Poland, which was supposed to ward off evil spirits.
Well, this certainly is supposed to get rid of evil spirits.
Welcome back to London, by the way. I didn't film the flight because I wasn't in a fucking
no
window
one cares
seat.
About that.
Isn't it? But I always get window seats to film the journey.
Did you not film any of the journeys?
I couldn't because I wasn't in a window seat.
Well, how will anyone know that you were?
How will they know I took a flight to London?
And how are you going to edit this together?
This bit is so fucking boring.
It's great. Okay. I'm really happy with that.
So far, I can just see something on the back. I like big books and I cannot lie. It says... What is this? This is amazing!
You see what I mean by it's going to ward off evil spirits?
Hazel, give a speech about why Hillary's great.
Because she's been there for some stuff, and she's been there for some stuff.
I hope that when this video goes live, we aren't all crying because of the results of the presidential election.
It's weird how sometimes life imitates art and vice versa. At the very end of October, something happened in my personal life that shook me a little bit. And so I fell massively far behind, all the while grappling with why it was so hard for me to continue the project when I didn't feel happy. Then, when I was ready to edit again, I watched all of this back and I was so taken aback by how present that theme was in this month. How my mental state could affect the filming and editing process for better or for worse. But likewise, how the project itself, just filming, editing, or watching it back could positively or negatively affect my mental state. I realised that in October I spoke to Amy Adams about how documenting my life could be either a blessing or a curse. How difficult it can be when you've been through like an upheaval in your life to look back at a time before that happened. And I made Happy This Month, a piece about how this series has positively affected my life. Recently, I met with publishers about the possibility of making Happy into an illustrated book, and the idea that I might have an actual book, a physical, real thing that'll be on bookshelves and people can buy and hold and read and engage with, that wouldn't exist if I hadn't made the series, is just astonishing to me. It's just so interesting to me that the series has become so intertwined with my life, and I suppose like that is a good thing. That is what every artist wants, ultimately. They want their life to affect it and it to affect their life. To make something that changes you in the process, and I suppose that affects other people too. As I draw to the end of this series, I'm really glad to realise that somewhere along the way, without really noticing it, I began to throw myself into it so fully that it's really become a part of my life now. I feel like my efforts haven't been wasted because as well as having all of this to look back on forever, I also have all the lessons that I've learned along the way about the process and about myself, and the knowledge that this will probably go on affecting me for a really long time in ways I can't even predict yet. As most of you know by now, I won't be continuing Time of the Month in 2017. So this is the third last episode, and I only have two more left to edit. It's sort of suddenly dawning on me that I'm going to be done with this pretty soon, and I am sad about it. I will miss it, I really will. But I'm excited at the same time. I'm excited for whatever the next project will be to come along and affect me so deeply. Guaranteed, though, there'll never be another one quite like this. That's been October.